I can look at the world and mathematize things. I can think of the light filling this room from a mathematical perspective and see beauty and underlying profound simplicity, and also power to make the world better in and that's what switches me on. I love the challenge of having this blank canvas. I love the flexibility of being able to interact with my audience's needs. If someone throws out a challenging question, I can answer it there and then on the spot. I think part of me also dislikes the fact that it's very low-tech in a world which is very high-tech. I like the simplicity of it. I like the flexibility of it. I also like the visceral nature of it, the bang of the chalk, the getting the sore arm when I'm writing, the clouds of dust, the physicality of lifting the boards up and down. I grew up in the western suburbs, and I feel more at home in the sort of grungier west side, and I particularly like living in an area which is filled with migrants, people from all cultures. Yeah. I sit on the bus and there'll be 15 different cultures in the bus, and you know, a quarter of them, a third of them will be fairly recent migrants. I really love that. My family were farmers. They migrated, both families, just after the Second World War from the north of Italy. So not a particularly academic background family at all. I really, really love gardening. Every Saturday I'll be out there digging and doing the compost, and I've got a push mower. I'm a bit of a greenie, which is why I catch the bus. Hey. To make mathematical physics a kind of software lens which can decode any form of image is one of the core things. It's actually highest on my list. We don't have the equivalent of these things that can be used to make bad imaging systems, such as me without my glasses, into good ones. So, question, can you use the power of mathematical physics to take bad images and make them into good ones? Then that would unlock huge potential to see individual atoms, to see chemistry occurring at the atomic level, to be able to image with unprecedented power the interior of the human body. If I invent a method and it's used in multiple labs worldwide regularly every day, then I'm doing a good thing. Why I teach, what drives me, it's about, I mean, in one word, it's about empowering the students, for them to make the world a better place, for them to want to, and for them to have the power to do so. And the power to do so through the analytical skills in whatever area I'm teaching that I can nurture in them. For me, what gets me up is every morning at 6 o'clock or 5 o'clock is, again, it sounds trite to say it, but how can I help people? Whether it's helping individual students or groups of students through the classes I'm involved in, or mentoring others, ex-students, more junior staff members, and also helping others through the research I do. So it all boils down to helping others, to making the world a better place as a way of defining and justifying my existence.